on Business Portal, it's part of the GP Rich client. And you can use it with requisitions. You can also use it without requisitions. If you use it with requisitions, and then the requisitions are simply going to feed, the approved requisition is going to be turned into a purchase order, eliminating all the need to just do additional data entry and just supplementing information. But if you want to use purchase order processing without requisitions, you can do that as well. And you can use either standard drop ship if you want the items drop shipped at remote locations or customer sites or employees' homes, for instance. And you could also do blanket purchase orders for items. You want to have a coffee order, you want it to come in every other week. This way you just keep having that purchase order regenerating on a time frame. And you can go ahead and change the status of the purchase order at the individual line items on the purchase order. So you might want to cancel one item and, you know, be able to receive the other ones. And you can also use purchase orders to complete the following tasks. You can enter and post shipment receipts, in transit receipts, and invoice receipts. So in addition, the purchase order does not create an accounting entry, but then you're able to go ahead and when you get the goods, you're able to sort of call up the purchase order and say, okay, I've gotten these goods in. And you can also do that for stuff that's on the water if you order from overseas. And you can either invoice receipts individually or in batches. And that's a pretty good point. So what happens, the same thing about shipments or invoices, receipts. So you might have a single purchase order, but it comes in, you know, little drips and drabs. So you're definitely able to accommodate that, you know, these four items were received. And then it's tracking what's outstanding on the purchase order, which is a good way for you to go ahead and just use for even for accruals at the end of the month to see what's outstanding. And we're doing this matching. We always refer to it as a three-way match. We're matching the purchase order against the shipment, against the vendor invoice, to ensure accuracy across all documents. Okay, so in addition to when you go to receive, you can also put landed costs. So if you've got handling fees, duty, shipping, any kind of custom fees, you can add that in addition to the product cost and track them separately. And this way you'll be able to analyze that separately as well. And you can automatically, if you're doing min-max levels, you can use the purchase order generator to automatically create purchase orders to replenish inventory quantity. So it will suggest to you when it's time to order. And if you're using project accounting, you can enter purchase orders and dropship purchase orders for projects. And the same thing with sales orders. If you're using sales order, you can commit purchase order line items to sales order, process line items to fill sales orders. So as you're ordering it, you're assigning to open customers' orders. And if you're using the purchase order enhancement model, you can approve and commit purchase orders and return receipts that have been received in a shipment or a shipment invoice receipt. I think we already covered that. Okay, so let's go into a demonstration now of purchase orders. So I'm just going to minimize this and go into GPay. So let's look at purchase order entry here. So you can see the yellow on the top means that there's workflow in here. So over and above workflow that's inside requisitions, we can also go ahead and put workflow on top of purchase orders themselves. But let's go ahead and look at some purchase orders that have already gone through, and we can start to see what they look like. So this is a standard purchase order. It's for advanced office system. And you can see the buyer IDs are over there, and these are the individual items they needed to order. If I wanted to do a new purchase order, I could do the same thing. And then what happens is the actions, I can either delete, void, submit it for workflow, or save it for later. So from the requisition that I've done, the purchase order comes inside here. And now it's an open purchase order, and it's going to be tracking that I need 10 green phones and one core for the total purchase order amount. So what, once it goes ahead and is from approval, let me just cancel over here. So once we have the purchase order, we can actually take you through the creation of a purchase order. So I'm going to say it's a standard purchase order. It's going to sign the next available purchase order. And again, if this had come from a requisition, I'd be seeing that coming in. And I select it. And then I choose the item that I want. And there's my phone. And I'm going to say I need two of them. And I'm going to say what location it goes to. That's fine. And then I simply go on to the next item. In this case, in this image here, I've got workflow enabled, so I would just submit it or save it for later. And now I'll be tracking each one of the open purchase orders. Again, if I've done requisitions coming from that. I'm going to save it here. So inside the purchase order has workflow, which I just went ahead and just showed you quickly. And note the status is not submitted. We just saw that in the real product. And what happens is you review the changes made to the workflow, and the history panel is going to be on this side over here once you submit it. If all conditions are met, then the submit for approval button, this window is launched, and this gives the opportunity to prioritize the document within the workflow and enter comments for the document, similar to what we saw for requisitions. Okay, so once the workflow goes ahead and kicks off, then what happens is that the person that needs to approve it is going to get the workflow email approval. And what's nice about this is they get an email in their inbox, and they're able to just have the jump right here that takes them right to the purchase order itself. So they don't have to just say, like, what's the $209 for? They can just open up the item itself and be able to go inside there and see the details about it and then be able to approve it. Okay, so once the purchase orders have been issued, they've been approved, then we have to just wait for the product to come in. And so that's where the three-way match kicks in. So we use the purchase order data to match against packing lists and vendor invoices. And that's ensuring that the price that we negotiated with the vendor for the purchase order matches up to what's on, matches up to the quantities that are arriving in-house, and then further match up to the dollar amounts on the invoices. So we're taking the purchase order and we're matching up the quantities that came in on the packing slip against the dollar amounts on the invoice, and that's our three-way match. And the PO data is retrieved, eliminating the need for manual entry. So you don't have to, you know, look through piles of paper or look through email sent. You just call up the purchase order data, and you're able to see right on screen what you're going against. And you can also see the price and quantity on the screen. So it also makes the receipts really efficient. And multiple receipts can be entered against a single purchase order. So let's just do a quick demonstration now of the three-way match. So I'm going to get out of here. And those are transactions that are going to be under purchasing, and I can go ahead and do receiving entries. Now, it can be one of two things. I can either put the shipment, I can either say, okay, I've got the goods, not the invoice, or I can do the shipment and invoice in one suite. It's the choice depending on the event. In this case, I'm just going to do the shipment. Once I go ahead and I call up, and it'll be number the receipt, I'll just go ahead and call up the vendor, and I'll call Advanced Office Systems. Let's see if you have the transactions. And then I can click on the button Auto Receive. When I click on Auto Receive, what that does is it brings up all the purchase orders that are open against this vendor. And you can see I've not selected any of them yet. But I'm going to say in my example here, of the purchase orders, that 75 and 76 both just came in. So I click on here. Oh, sorry. We'll say 77, 78. 75 and 76 are still in some approval, so they're not available for it. They're actually going through encumbrance. So I'm going to say take 75 and 78, and I click on receive. And it's just that easy. So I don't have to rekey in anything. The receipt has all been populated for me. The quantities are in there. I can override them. If there's a price in there and I've given a tolerance, I can override that as well. And if I need to either put some shipping charges or some landed costs in there, or change the general ledger distribution, or put some user-defined information, I can. And in this case, I'm just going to save it. And I'll just open up a batch. And I could also post it if that's what I want to do. So now the receipt has been put in there, but the invoice has not been put in there. So I can either post the batch and enter the invoice, or I'll just show you quickly how we enter invoices. It's very, very similar. Sorry, it's right over here. We go into purchasing, and then we go enter match invoices. So now I'm putting the vendor's invoice number. Note that I'm not in the accounts payable screens. I'm actually going into the purchasing screens because I'm going to be calling up more information. And now I call up the purchase order. It's going to find all the individual purchase orders. And I'll say it's 81. And then I can say what is the actual, I can actually go into auto invoice. And it'll call up all the information for me. And maybe it came in at, you know, $90.27. I can always adjust it here, and I can put some notes in, and I can put it for the invoice. And when I post this, it's now going to post to accounts payable, eliminating the need for the accounts payable people to enter the invoices. They can just receive it in an open batch, or I can post through if that's their preference. So this just goes ahead and streamlines the whole process across the organization, and that's a quick example of the three-way match.